I'm going to show you how to create a beautiful and practical construction estimate template in Excel. This template is based on practical experience. I helped my husband, who is in the construction and remodeling field, design a similar one for his own use. No matter your industry, this video demonstrates how to create and format any type of business template. Open a new Excel file. I like to right away apply my preferred font to the template. I will use Century Gothic at 11 point size. I will give my template a title, in my case, Construction Estimate, and make it bold at 18 points. The first item that I will want to list are the hourly rates for the main carpenter and his helper. I will also create placeholders for markups on labor and material. You may add or edit these variables as they fit your field. I incorporate formatting throughout my design process. The first thing I want to remove are the grid lines to make the template look clean. To emphasize the rates and markups, I will make them bold and fill with color. I will name my tab Summary, and before I lose any changes, I will name my workbook and save it. On the Summary tab, I will want to have a summary of all the trades in the worksheet, starting with prep work for a construction project. To give my data some room, I will add numbers in the first column and adjust its size. Now I'm going to add my hourly rates for the main and helper carpenters. I am ready to start adding some detail for each part of the project. The first trade will be prep work, and thus the name for my new tab. Under description, I will write all the tasks that need to be done. I will add numbers on the left up to 25 tasks per trade. Now, I will add a few more columns of needed data. These include the type of work, which is sometimes used to track different work types in some construction estimates, and the hours for both the main and assistant carpenters. The next two columns will be subtotals for the charges associated with each task. Now I'm going to enter some sample hours for each task for both workers. For formatting, I will center the hours and remove the grid lines. In the next step, I want to set up job description categories so I can use them repeatedly without having to think about them each time. I will add a categories tab in my template. Under the description section, I will begin listing the typical tasks that may be required for a standard construction project. I will also copy over all the task descriptions from my prep work and add few more. There are some duplicates and misspellings which I will clean up shortly. If you have a previous project, you can copy and paste all the job descriptions to build a comprehensive list. I will highlight my list and spell check it first. Next, I will sort them alphabetically to make it easier to find task descriptions in drop-down menu. Finally, I will remove any duplicates. I like to highlight the area that will serve as reference for data validation. Leave few extra empty rows in case more task descriptions need to be added while working on the project. I color code the area so I can quickly tell which rows are being used under data validation. I will apply the same approach to categorizing the type of work. For now, I will label the categories as general, plumbing, or electric. It is good to add a space between the categories so when you want to sort them, they don't affect each other. Now I'm going back to my prep work, which I've been setting up as a reference tab to copy and use for other part of the project. To add the work description categories to a pull-down menu, select all the rows, go to Data Validation, and choose the List option. Source will be the color-coded description that are on the Categories tab. I will apply the same approach to categorizing the types of work. To use the drop-downs, select each row and choose an option from the drop-down menu. If you can't find your description, start typing. An option that matches the initial letters will appear. Then press Enter. Last, I will add few more work hours for the main and assistant carpenter. For the next step in the setup, I like to open a new window of my file. This allows me to easily reference and link between sections side by side. We have hours for our workers, but now we want to calculate the costs for each of the tasks under prep work. To calculate the subtotal for the main carpenter, I will multiply the hours required for the task by the hourly rate listed on the summary tab. I kept the hourly rates and markups on the summary tab, so any changes will automatically flow through the entire template. I will set the reference to the rates as absolute so that copying formulas won't alter the reference to cell D2 on the summary tab. To copy the formulas down, I can double-click on the lower right corner. I will do the same to calculate the subtotal for the helper carpenter work. Keep it absolute and link to the rate on the summary tab. Another way to copy the formula is to grab the right corner and drag it down. The current format for the subtotals is set to currency, which displays zeros in empty rows and looks cluttered. I will change the format to accounting, which replaces zeros with dashes, creating a much cleaner look. Now I will add a bit of formatting. I removed grid lines from the entire sheet, but I will add borders to the areas with data, so it is more readable across rows. To improve readability across long columns, I will add a light gray color every two rows to create an alternating row pattern. To paste formats from one area to another, use the Paint Format icon. To center a title across columns, I will use the Merge and Center option from the menu and label my columns under Labor for now. Let's add two more columns. The first will be the total labor costs, which adds the subtotal for the main and helper carpenter. I will use the subtotal function with the function number 9 for summing to prevent any double counting now and as I extend the template later on. At this stage, the totals only account for direct costs and do not include overhead costs like administrative, office, insurance, utilities, marketing, equipment, licensing, and permit expenses. To cover these overhead costs, you need to apply a markup to labor costs. I will go back to the summary tab and add my markups. When setting pricing for construction projects or other businesses, it's crucial to establish a markup that not only covers overhead costs, but also generates a profit. Simply breaking even is insufficient as unexpected expenses do arise. Do research on your industry, but for construction, a good reference is the builder.com website. They recommend markups on labor above 25% and for materials between 30 and 50%. A percentage can be expressed as a decimal by dividing it by 100. When we use a decimal greater than 1, it represents an increase over the original value. For example, if you set up a markup of 1.3, it means the price will be increased by 30%. Here's why. 1.3 is the decimal equivalent of 130%. The 1 represents the original amount and the 0.3 represents an additional 30%. So multiplying by 1.3 adds 30% to the original amount. Now I'm ready to use it in my calculations. I will go back to my prep work tab, then multiply the labor costs by the labor markup of 1.3. I will make the reference absolute. I will also apply the styling from the other columns to my totals and extend the labor title. Now, what would be helpful is to have totals for the hours for each carpenter and job costs. So I will add a sum at the bottom of the columns. To select a range, you can use the keyboard or your mouse to make a selection. Final touches is to emphasize the total at the bottom. For each trade, starting with prep work, I want to copy the summary calculations to the summary tab. To link them, I will bring my other Excel window with a Mac shortcut command accent key, or on a PC use the Ctrl plus tab or Ctrl plus F6. Then link for the total for labor cost. If I make the reference absolute and copy it over, it will stay the same. So I have to do the linking twice, once for pre and once for post markup. We have completed the labor cost calculations. Next, I will add the materials cost. To keep things organized, I will temporarily hide the labor columns using the free panes. I will add two columns for materials. One for the actual cost of the materials and another for the costs with applied markup. Let me paste the format from the labor columns before I perform the calculations. I will take the material cost and multiply it by the markup of 1.5 from the summary tab as an absolute reference. Then copy the formula down and apply consistent formatting. The last column that I want to have is a total that will be given to the customer. That's a straightforward addition of the post-markup labor and material costs. Now I will go back to my summary tab and add the material and total to customer columns and individually link them as absolute values to my prep work tab. This is a good setup for a large-scale construction project. Eventually, I will have many different trades in the file, and to move and find them quicker, I will create hyperlinks. Select the cell, right-click, and go to Hyperlink. Then choose the correct tab under In This Document. When I select the cell now, I jump to the Prep Work tab. Perfect. Once the file becomes large, I would like a quick way to navigate back to the summary tab from any other tab. So I will add a hyperlink on the prep work tab as well. I can test this navigation and it works great and is a quick way to move about a large file. At this point, I am done setting up my pre-work tab as a template for other trades. Now I am ready to make a copy of it by right-clicking on it, then going to Move or Copy and checking the Create a Copy option. I will give this tab a name, Demo Work, then delete all the sections applicable to prep work. Make sure you don't delete any formulas. Now I will customize it for demo work by selecting new tasks under the description and adding work hours for the main and helper carpenters. I will also add some example material charges to make this example more comprehensive. Currently, the data for demo work is not appearing on the summary tab, so I have to link to it. I will make a copy of the prep work row, then select only that row and go to Find and Replace. I want to find all instances in the formula in the row of prep work and replace it with demo work. Make sure you don't add any spaces to the name. It has to match exactly to the names of the tabs in the file. That was so quick and much less work to do. I do want to double check to make sure it linked the numbers correctly. The final thing I need to fix is to change the hyperlink from prep work to the demo work tab. Now I'm going to add another tab and leave it blank. I will also update the titles on each tab. Then relink the data as I done before by finding and replacing the prep work links with the new work tree name. Next, I will copy the work tree tab 5 more times to prepare for future trades. You can add as many as you need and always create more later. On the summary tab, I will duplicate the first row 5 more times and relink them using the find and replace. Last thing I need to do is update the hyperlinks and test them. The summary will update as I update more trade data on each tab. On the summary tab, I will use the auto sum option to sum up all the labor, materials, and total to customer columns. Right now, I can't tell what is my profit margin on this project. Let's calculate it. I will calculate the gross profit and gross margin once I have determined the total revenue and the costs for the labor and material on the project. The total revenue is the total paid by the customer. The cost of the labor and material are the pre-markup amounts. These are the actual costs. Gross profit is the total revenue less the two costs. In this example, on the total revenue of $12,000, we made a gross profit of $3,500. This amount must cover overhead costs, taxes, and ideally leave some for savings and investments. Dividing the gross profit by the revenue gives us a gross margin of 29%. Not bad. Now, we can easily change the hourly rates and markups to run different scenarios. Here is a general rule. If you want your profit margin to be at least 23%, your markup needs to be 30% or 1.3. If you want your profit margin to be at least 37%, your markup would need to be 1.6. If you have two variables, such as labor and materials with different markup rates, both will affect your gross margin. You can also add a payment schedule to your template and calculate the required invoice amount based on the work completed. But that's a topic for another video. Let me know in the comments section if you would like a step-by-step tutorial on how to do this. Thanks so much for watching.